With talk of land expropriation in South Africa dominating headlines and making investors uncomfortable, not to mention catching the attention of US President Donald Trump, President Cyril Ramaphosa has penned an op-ed to try and bring calm to concerns around the state's plans. As with government's national health insurance scheme, one of the biggest criticisms with the state's handling of land expropriation without compensation has been the lack of clarity around how it will be implemented. This has led to a degree of panic among farmers, who have had to deal with so-called leaked lists of targeted farms amid EFF-led land grabs, and lingering uncertainty among investors and economists. Contrary to Ramaphosa's stated goal of not letting land redistribution affect the economy, government's dragging of the subject with no clarity forthcoming has actually been an underlying factor in the continued volatility in local markets. This was pushed to another level this week, when Donald Trump waded into the land debate on his favored soapbox, Twitter, saying that the US government would study land seizures and farm murders in South Africa, sending markets into yet another spin. Whether prompted by Trump's utterances or by the growing need for clarity, President Ramaphosa took to the Financial Times to try point out where everyone is getting the state's land expropriation plans wrong. A planned amendment to the Constitution is still work in progress, with public hearings on the matter concluding this month. Here are the seven main points highlighted by the president. First and foremost, Ramaphosa stressed that there are, and will be, no state-sanctioned land grabs. While the Economic Freedom Fighters actively encourages the illegal occupancy of private land, government's plans are not to take part in or encourage illegal activity. The ANC has been clear that its land reform program should not undermine future investment in the economy or damage agricultural production and food security, Ramaphosa said. The government has also explicitly stated that it would take action against anyone who breaks the country's laws. The proposals will not erode property rights, but will instead ensure that the rights of all South Africans, and not just those who currently own land, are strengthened, the president said. The goal is to make land accessible to those who work the land, and that those rights are also protected. The EFF's policy of nationalizing all land to be state-owned is not the goal.